Kim, I want to apologize for the noise. In regards to Cushing, Tim has talked to the guy. They have trucks come in for diesel and stuff, but they have no idea what is running, but it's economical for both parties. It's obviously economical for us, but these guys have no idea what it's going to cost them to run. And they're just going to get paid back by us based on the requested energy, which is hitting hard times, you know, what it costs them. Yeah, I mean, like I said, we breached. Anyway. So, you know, more than likely. Go ahead. No, but he did say that he contacted his natural gas guy and they thought they could get him some, but no idea on price. And then, and he understands we've been pretty much a buyer too, so we haven't been actually selling. He just, but If they really want to investigate, I think they're going to look at the ice bids and stuff. Because there's culprits out there. That's the same thing that I've heard from several people out there running up the gas market. So we've agreed to at least have an email stream of some sort of document of evidence that we are trying to procure fuel on the EOIT pipeline for our run, for our, at least Ben runs on direct. And that way, you know, it may not be a price you like, but at this point, OGT nor Naval. So, any OFOs, operational flow, so it appears that. So. I think them, ONG, I think there's going to, like I said. But anyway, the only downside we consider this is right now, we're, you know, SPP did this day before day ahead run, DBDA. And so they're using, we think, because we're not real clear, neither is OG&E, the 12th offer curves to commit units on the 15th. Instead of just the building that offers one day OD plus one to commit these things. And so if that's the case, they're still using our offer curves with the first run at gas prices for Redbud. I held the distance clear 173 when the DBDA offers had to be in the 2000s, and I had no idea. And so, knowing that participants are, you know, based on what they're submitting to the MMU, are leaving the participants on the hook if they actually clear these things on the hook for buying gas recovery right now. If we start getting OFOs or SPP says that we have to buy it, then that's another story. Commitment. And then we found out that the DBDA is what there's just so many moving parts right now. I mean, I totally agree. Like, they've already committed us for the 15th. Anyway, we're trying to pull it all together, and things are changing quickly, so it's a matter of trying to keep our heads above water. You know, we got a call with OG&E, and 1 minute, so I need to get up here and talk to them about real-time offers. All right, I'll continue to update you when I get it. All right, talk to you later, Jeff. Do pull gas in, or anything else. It's always, so they're gonna work on figuring that out today. That's what we've asked them to do. So I think he's comfortable not running it, but if we have enough information to maybe put him in for, you know, a couple hours, then we need to do it, or we could do it. They could put online with just a diesel that they have. I know they can't put on all 11, but they know which ones they could. Yeah, this one, if we do that, if we do this, if we do. EOIT, if we actually have an email screen or a record of us, what they did. So he goes, I understand, and I get the reason why you want to put out some sort of documented evidence. So he has no problem doing that for us. So what I might want to do, at least I least what bid we want to put out there, even if it's slightly over. If we could run 15 units. They could run for 24 hours, they just can't run all 11 for 24 hours. No, I think their spaces keep on getting gas in. And she estimates probably $120 is what we would end up paying them for the generation. So that would probably work at least on the on-peak portion, or at least the dual peaks. And but we have no idea yet how many units they can actually run. And so that's what we're asking. Yes, all diesel. If I don't die of a heart attack in the next week, then it'll be good. So,